So Belen, you have 15 minutes to present. Then the guests will leave and you will be asked questions by the commission.
Okay.
You can start.
Hello everybody, I'm going to present about the integration of translation and its effect on oral production in English. First of all, from where I observed in my internship, the thing that caught my attention was the lack of communication I heard from the students. And also I think that it's a big challenge because I observed that students tend to communicate most of the time in Spanish. And I decided to investigate about the cost. But what I observed was that the method was really important, and that the method included the students. And according to Minelu, oral expression can be challenging because students should consider many factors when communicating, for example, pronunciation, vocabulary, language structures, all at the same time. So it's important that it's challenging for students. The context is in Maryland School of Cuenca. I was in a 7th grade with 24 students, and weaknesses related to oral production were mainly related to pronunciation, lack of vocabulary, and that was the thing I found really interesting to investigate, that they try to avoid using English during the class. The way in which English was instructed was with the use of the grammar translation method. These are some of the activities students did during the class I observed. For example, check the meaning in Spanish of irregular verbs of the course. So it's centered on grammar and in the use of Spanish, mainly. Also, students translated sentences and words in order to understand their meaning. And the last but not least is that they insert words in English and they translated them into Spanish immediately. And that was the thing that caught my attention most. That they observed a word and they were asked, used to translate everything that they immediately pronounced the word in Spanish. the class. Also, I have another author that is Leonardo, 2010, that suggested that this method was criticized and unsuitable, the seeking for more natural and communicative approaches. And after the process of validity, advisors and peers they give me they helped me to involve my study and even my state, because it was about defining strategies that the teacher used. And I was advised to focus on one thing, and I decided to work just on translation and its effect. And to define also what I meant by oral production, and I choose communicability. My material is an observational checklist that includes certain statements that reflect the use of language or oral production in English, which for example a positive number, and in that checklist. And those statements, the statements which reflect the avoidance or dependence to Spanish, where assigned negative numbers in order to subtract points. And this is the checklist. So we have positive numbers, and then we have negative numbers in order to subtract points. So when we calculate the result, we can obtain a positive or negative number. They obtain, for example, a positive number when there is a direct use of English. And when there is when they answer a question in a truth, directly. And they obtain negative numbers when they, for example, read words written in L2, but they pronounce them in L1. So they were avoiding the use of English. It's important to clarify that in the grammar translation method, the principles state that the use of Spanish is a vehicle for understanding the meaning, so it won't represent a problem in that method. But as this study is focused on oral production in English, that was assigned a negative number. And another conclusion was that there was a big group of students in the class, so some of the statements, maybe if some students did something, it may be probably it would have been ignored because of the great number, but I try to be as accurate as possible. And this is what I obtained from this course during the translation, during the class that used translation as a main strategy in blue. And in orange, you have the course while the direct method was used. And they are mainly about the use of translation. Only three of them are under the result using the direct method. I use a verb t-test in order to compare and have a difference between the results obtained before and after the use of the new methodology. And in order to know if the differences were significant, I test the null hypothesis that says that the mean of this difference differences is equal to zero. And I choose an average alternative that says that the mean would be greater than zero. And that was the mean for point F. And for you to have a better view of the differences in this code, they are shown here. These are just the differences between the pre and the post. And there you can see that three students obtain a lower score. And the other students. So these are the results according to the performance I observed. 95.8% obtain a better result using the new methodology. And 4.2 obtain it was using the direct method and the audiolingual method, they take a better measurement of the 4.2%. And the other person improved in order to, according to, in terms of oral production. So it says that it suggests that there is a great tendency to improve in that in this area, talking about oral production, using these methodologies, because also it is stated in the principles by Larson and Manfred that both are oral-based approaches and that translation can be centered on other skills. But I wanted to taste that, to test that. As I told you before, the grammar translation is centered on writing and reading instead of speaking. And it represents that a deviation from the increasing amounts of oral production in the EFL classroom. Because there is not a focus on communication. And the other methods are focused more on speaking. And my metacognitive analysis is about an objective of 7th grade that is objective aprendizaje 8. And it's about oral production. And the main contents are concerned with the communication and description of feelings and moods of people. And also about some expressions of quantity and time. The strengths I find in my teaching style, can I say, is being friendly and close to the students in order to create a positive and comfortable environment. And for example, having a friendly tone of voice and positive attitude towards students, and which promote their participation. And I support this with the Sociospedia method principles that said that states the importance of the creation of a positive environment. My weaknesses, the weaknesses I have identified during my internship is that sometimes I feel insecure about unexpected situations or problems that occur in the internship. These problems can be caused by different factors, family problems, home factors, feelings of inadequacy and financial problems. Different factors, as cited in maths 1999. And And because that doesn't have to affect your class, for example. And the challenge I found in the program of the studio that is to have a critical thinking. You have to because it says un pensador crítico con la pregunta y problema en forma clara y precisa recoge y evalúa información relevante, llega a soluciones y conclusiones guiadas por el razonamiento y la reflexión. This can be used with your students, but also in your own teaching style. It is necessary for teachers to find what's better for their students and for him or herself. And it also says, piensa con una mentalidad que se comunica de forma efectiva, which is important also for teachers to solve problems, to help students, to solve any problem that you might face. And some of the references. Thanks.